Rick, I'm working with a husky mix and wondering what it is I could do to get through the stubbornness. He will not listen to commands unless he wants to.
Training. So this is what I want you to do. Who's that, Rick?
Yes.
Rick's a trainer? Okay.
I'm assuming.
Rick, 100% responsibility. It's your skill set. Got it? That doesn't make me the best trainer. That doesn't make me a great trainer at all. But I'm not going to blame the dog at all. So stubbornness you're going to get a lot of. So look at this as a learning opportunity for you. So say, what is my skill set lacking in? Not the dog's, you know, learning ability. All right? Next.
Going live. Now we're live.
And we're live. Hey, everybody. How are you? It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. It is Friday night. We're doing a live it is Friday night, correct? It's not Saturday night?
Uh-huh.
We're doing live from the training center here in Providence, Rhode Island. We're in the middle of T3. We've got an audience in front of me. In fact, let me just see this, if this feature is working. Oh, look at that. There's the live.
Volume's
good. There's a live audience right there. Live studio audience. Hey, everybody. How are you?
Live studio audience. That's right.
There we go. That's right. We opened up the show. We had a juggler. We had a comedian. We had a stripper. You guys missed it all. So that'll be up on my Patreon channel for $25. This is a Q&A show. We do this three times a week, historically, Mondays, Wednesdays, and Saturday nights, 8 p.m. This is going to be a 90-minute show. It's Q&A. My training center up in Providence, we really specialize in aggression rehab, behavior mod, lots of leash reactivity, just some really, really intense behaviors dogs are trying to stop. But we also deal with puppies here and basic obedience, advanced obedience. Now, the seminar series that I do, Jeff Gellman Seminars, you can go to jeffgellmanseminars.com. And what you can do is you can see the schedule. I'm coming to be in Vancouver, I'm coming for you. We're going to have a lot of fun, a lot of nonsense going on in Vancouver right now, but I'm here for you. Don't worry, I'll be there. And then after that, we've got Alaska. We're going to be up there in Alaska. We've got Hawaii this year. This is what we're going to do. The show is also a problem-solving show. So my seminars and my show that you're about to watch is a problem-solving show. Most questions, if you follow along, are how do I stop, how do I stop, how do I stop? So in order to stop an unwanted behavior, we have to start talking about a punisher, punishment. Now, people need to learn how to apply a punisher, and the art of applying a punisher, remember, you're not mad, you're not upset. So we're going to talk a lot about shock collars. If you want to call it a remote collar, that's fine. If you want to call punishment a correction, that is fine. We're going to be talking about a bonker. If you don't know what a bonker is, it is a wrapped-up towel. Believe it or not, one of the best punishers we have. Yes, we can actually stop a dog from killing sheep, chasing a horse, getting into dog fights, loading many things. And we also utilize prong collars. And we also utilize leash, but also we also use food and we use clickers. In fact, we do tons of food training at our training center here. But this is all going to be punishment-based. So please put that into context. Ask a question. At the bottom of your screen, there's a little dollar sign. People want to know, why are all these like dollar amounts popping up sometimes? That's something called Top Chat. It's something that YouTube puts out for creators that put out content. A lot of people like to just throw us a little bit, and just thank you for the 15 years of free help that has been helping them with their dogs. Remember, you can really transform your dogs by our YouTube videos. Most of the questions we get, it really needs a six-week board and train, but you're going to get a 30-second answer. If you need more than that, we've got so many free resources. And then, obviously, there's also Skypes and one-on-ones and seminars, and then there's board and train after that. But you do not have to pay to play. Ask your question. It will be answered in the order that we get it. So don't be impatient. If we don't get to it right away, we are going in order. Top chats do go to the top of the queue. This is Joelle. She's one of the trainers here. She is also my co-host on my show, and you'll see her at the seminar. She travels with me. So she asks the questions. I give the answers. Simple concept. Here we go.
Here we go. Nicole. Hey, guys. Hey, Nicole.
Hey, Nicole. How are you?
Melissa says, good evening, all.
Oh, hey, Melissa. How you doing?
Aiden says hi. Annie says hi, team. Awesome.
Awesome.
Nicole, question for a friend. She says...
Okay.
Asking for a friend.
Asking for a friend.
Hint, hint. All right, you ready? She says, prong collar made GSD more vocal with reactivity. Why or how to fix?
Okay, so the reason why it's because it's probably working. This is the thing. It could have been a timing issue. Just remember, when the dog is starting to load and take energy and moving it out, and you've got a prong collar, and if you just like stood still and the dog went against the prong collar, the dog's going to vocalize. Also, shepherds are vocal. And then also, if the dog went that way and you went that way, there is a combination of surprise and discomfort. So what you can start doing is, usually it's a timing issue. The earlier you apply your punisher, which is the beginning of the sequence of the arousal, and we're going to talk about that a lot tonight, the vocalization sometimes stops. But vocalization doesn't last forever. But think about this. We had a dog in here named Ranger, and a slip lead. Name the collar that you like. Just slip lead, flat buckle collar, one that you align with besides what we use, okay? Just touching it like this made the dog scream for like 5 minutes straight. So there are vocal dogs. Shepherds tend to be them as well. Next.
Donna says hello.
Hey, Donna, how are you?
Abby, good evening, Jeff, Joelle, and everyone else. How do you use a remote collar to teach dog to ignore stuff, cats, people, other dogs, on and off leash?
Let's talk about on leash first, because that's going to help you out a lot. This is the thing. I don't know your skill set, and I don't know how intense the dog is. So I'm going to use that phrase a lot, and that's not some bullshit reason not to give you an answer, because there is a lot of context that we need. But what you can start doing is, you can start teaching your dog that when they feel stimulation, they should look away from something. So that's what it is. So the theory is, who's this, Donna? Donna.
Is Abby. It
Abby? Abby, if I'm looking at your boobs, all right, and you stroke my arm, I'm going to still keep looking at your boobs. I might even touch them at that point. But if you kick me in the fucking balls, I'm probably going to look away. So
don't
kick the dog in the balls, but you've got to figure out the level in between stroking and kicking that your dog goes, I don't want to look at that thing anymore. That's what you're trying to do. Next.
Don't stroke the arousal. Julie. That's right. Hi, Jeff. I missed the timing to use a bonker on my dog to stop the behavior of getting up onto the window and barking. Is there anything I can do to stop her once she's crazy aroused?
You try again. Try bonking again. This is the thing. This is what I want you to do. Today we worked with a dog named Gus, guys? Gus?
Yeah.
Gus. We were with a dog named Gus. Now, Gus has been bonked before. I actually said no, and he actually started moving away from me. So when I threw the bonker, it hit the floor. The dog didn't move. Now, this is what I want you to do. Dog on a leash. Walk up to the window. As soon as that dog starts looking out the window, no, bonk. Hard. Hard as you can. Yes, on the head. Oh. And if you saw the video about how a bonking gave a dog blunt force trauma, and if you believe it, you have bigger issues, because it just doesn't happen. You won't hurt your dog when you bonk your dog. So it's really important. Now your dog understands what no means. So even if you said no and missed, your dog is pretty much going to react like, holy shit, that sucked. So that's what you're going to do. Next.
Annie, Joelle, your hair looks awesome tonight.
It does.
Jeff, you look good as well.
Guys,
thanks, Annie.
Do me a big favor. If you compliment Joelle,
stop.
End it there. She needs. Like, don't throw in.
Thank you. I don't need it. Okay?
Don't throw in and Jeff. Don't do the and Jeff. Just give her all of the compliments. Next.
The last time he made a comment like that, happened to his forehead. So let's keep that in mind. Chloe.
That wasn't from stroking either.
Hey, J&J, in your opinion, is a yoga mat substantial enough to keep in the car and expect the dog to hold place on it at picnics, the lake, etc.?
Yeah, I mean, you can use a washcloth. Guys, animal actors are sent to a spot. The way it's trained is, it's a big mat, a smaller mat, a really small mat, and eventually a piece of tape on the ground, and the dogs are literally sent to place. So place is place is place. So absolutely. Next.
Do you not want me to read this one or no?
No.
Okay.
Next.
Hold on, dog training. Happy effing Friday. Thanks for the tip on the down in the kennel totally worked better. Wish I was there for T3. I'm totally jealous of all you sitting there.
No problem at all. They're all exhausted and tired of us, so, but
I can't even believe you guys are here.
I know. I'm surprised.
My God.
I'm surprised. Next.
Cheyenne, there was a random cat in the backyard and my dog saw it and went to go chase it down, but I said, no, leave it here. Didn't even have to press the button on his e-collar and he came right back.
Wow, that's a lot of commands.
One of the best days.
Which one worked?
Not done yet.
Okay.
One of the best days he's had so far. We've only been working with the e-collar for about a couple of days.
So actually, believe it or not, Cheyenne, first of all, Cheyenne, fucking awesome. Kudos to you. Next time, push the button as well. And I know the dog, responded, but you've only been working on it for a couple of times. So are you going to confuse the dog? Are you going to like, oh my God, my dog's coming back and I'm shocking him? When you said, leave it, whatever you said, push the button. Push the button, just in case. Because once that dog goes into drive, you're screwed. Next.
Do you want me to read this one? There's a lot of like weird questions.
Okay, then don't read the weird ones.
All right, Ari. Hey, T3 gang. Thoughts on a negative marker version of a clicker? Was told about trainers using it to mark.
Okay,
a
you're
note.
Done. I don't talk science. Next. No, I won't answer that one.
Using a marked a no instead of a yes, I thought that seemed pretty useful.
Oh yes, I'll try to answer that.
A negative marker okay. instead of a clicker.
Because negative marker was sciencey. And you know
this
I don't
know. Ari, you know who this is.
Oh, it's Ari?
Don't be rude.
Oh, Ari, I'll answer any question you ask. What was it again?
Exactly.
Ari. Ari, we used Ari in a clip.
We did today.
Yeah, today.
Did you see it?
Did you see it? Yeah, it was good. Okay. So I got it. Okay, start all over again.
Thoughts on a negative marker version of a clicker. I was told about trainers using it to mark a no instead of a yes. I guess a big tone on the remote. We do that sometimes.
Okay. But when you said negative marker and clicker, I was like, people are going to get too confused with that. So I don't want you to use the clicker as a negative marker. You can use tone on the remote collar as a negative marker. You can use the word no as a negative marker. Theoretically, you could turn the clicker into a negative marker, but you can't just use it for a positive marker. Mm-hmm. So anything that is consistent and you follow it up with a punisher will be your negative marker. Does that make sense? So you can use a sound and then a consequence, and there's your negative marker, whatever that sound was, or anything. Next.
Or the word no.
Or the word no.
Kevin
which
says...
would be a sound.
Yeah.
No. Next.
I can't. Kevin says you guys are the best.
Thank you. Julie. You wrote that before I answered that question, though.
Julie, by the way, me and my girl Lily, 4-year-old pit bull mix with no prior training... We had a great walk today with our prong
awesome.
Collar and loose leash.
Awesome.
Your videos are awesome and so helping me.
Awesome. And don't discount the hard work that you put into it. Next.
Antonio, I adopted a 6-month-old Amstaff and we've been working on him existing around people.
Awesome.
He is great with strangers in my home, but in public he growls. Any more advice? I get him out as much as I can.
Yes, give a consequence for the growling. It's normal. What I want you to do is make sure you're utilizing a little bit of space. Don't let people pet the dog. Okay, don't let people pet the dog. And then what I want you to do is if there's any growling, you can say no, which is your negative marker, and pop with the leash. Next.
Full of sass tonight. Michelle Anderson, our number one YouTube fan.
Yes.
Good evening, Jeff and Joelle. Hope T3 is going awesome.
It's going fantastic. Thank you, Michelle. We love you.
Tammy says, hi, Jeff and Joelle.
Tammy, hello.
Juan, hey, Jeff and Joelle. Just dropping in to say hi and learn. Hope you guys are doing well.
Things are fantastic, Juan.
Feisty pet training and boarding. When, how often do you answer your Patreon Q&A?
Not enough.
Yeah. No shit.
I was waiting to get shit for that this week. Let's see. I'll make a video tonight between 1 a.m. and 2 a.m. I'd be high. Guys, I was up last night till 1 o'clock installing air conditioners in my fucking house because there's a heat wave.
I can't believe it took you this long. I threatened to boycott the freaking show.
Next.
He has nothing to say. Julie, we are still working with a lot of leash reactivity and are walking a lot with leash pressure. I don't know what else.
Walking with leash pressure?
Walking a lot with leash pressure. There shouldn't be any. Obviously at the end of the leash.
So the dog's pulling. Okay, what I need you to do is work on your leash handling skills. I have no idea how you're holding the leash. Prong collar, the chain on the back is not supposed to be forming a triangle. It's supposed to be flat against the dog's back. What you might be doing is you might not be popping soon enough. You might be missing the arousal stages. Also, what I want you to do is do the pre-walk bonker. The beginning of your walk, stand still. If the dog's even scanning around, no. Bonk. I want you to do that. Look into remote collar healing. It could be a timing issue. You might be being more reactive than proactive. I'm not sure at all what's going on. Next.
Amy, how to stop my dog from walking up to people. He is polite, off-leash reliable, holds commands, but I want him to not assume he can walk up to people unless I give permission. Thanks, I love you.
I love you too. Is he off-leash or on-leash?
Off-leash reliable.
Okay. Well, who runs the show? You or the dog? So let's start out with this. First of all, you don't want him to walk up to people unless you say so. Let's go on a six-month hiatus. You don't walk up to anybody. Let's not confuse the dog. You know, yes, and in a perfect world, you should be able to do both, but let's just do this. Keep your dog next to you. Don't let people pet the dog. You don't approach the dog. All right? Teach the dog that. If the dog is interested in people, tell it no. The dog's not going to all of a sudden turn into somebody that bites people. You can have a dog that is social but not interested in people, because that's what we do. That's what we do. Next.
Nicole, awesome. Thank you for that answer.
Oh, you're welcome, Nicole.
Lindsay, taught 7-month-old German Shepherd recall with treats. How do I start to wean off them so she comes without them? Give them to her every other time she comes and then start to every 2 or 3?
Well, you can start gradually getting rid of them, but you're going to need to apply a punisher for non-compliance of coming back. So food fails eventually. Eventually the food will fail. So what's going to happen is there will be a point when even the food doesn't work and your dog's not going to respond. What you need to do is you need to be able to tell your dog no and have a consequence. So whether that's using a long line and a prong collar or a remote collar. So that's what you need. So you can do it tomorrow, start tomorrow, but unfortunately just weaning the dog off, it's there's always something better than food out there. Next.
Mr. Flo, hey there, got a dog that's been adopted during summer, therefore got a lot of attention. Fall came, she obtained less attention and started to have separation anxiety, crying, etc.
Mm-hmm.
That's all.
So, statement, question.
Statement, but I'm assuming
okay. So I'm assuming you want it fixed. Okay. Go. I've got a video on my YouTube channel. It's on separation anxiety. Watch that. More structure. But watch the video. Watch the video on separation anxiety, and then we'll see you on Monday show. Next.
Rick, I'm working with a husky mix and wondering what it is I could do to get through the stubbornness. He will not listen to commands unless he wants to.
Training. So this is what I want you to do. Who's that, Rick?
Yes.
Rick's a trainer? Okay.
I'm assuming.
Rick, 100% responsibility. It's your skill set. Got it? That doesn't make me the best trainer. That doesn't make me a great trainer at all. But I'm not going to blame the dog at all. So stubbornness, you're going to get a lot of. So look at this as a learning opportunity for you. So say, what is my skill set lacking in? Not the dog's, you know, learning ability. All right? Next.
Lindsay, how do I apply a punisher every time my dog does not come when called? I can't throw a bonker halfway across the yard. When she ignores me, correct her high on the e-collar?
Not necessarily. So what I want you to do is this. You have to teach your dog how to be punished. You have to teach your dog how to be punished, because what you're going to do is if your dog is off leash and it's ignoring you and you just shock your dog might run the other way. Your dog doesn't understand what that means. So what you're going to do is have a long line on the dog, say no, correct high, but then guide your dog back. Also, you can say the here command again. Guide your dog back to. The dog needs to understand what it is that you want it to do, or else the dog can actually flee. Next.
Charles, boobs, balls, arousal, and a studio audience. Damn, show hit a new level, and I don't even have a dog yet.
See that? Wait till you do. Pants come off. Next.
We're waiting. Julie, I love the bonker.
Thank you. Bonker is one of the best tools out there.
Lindsay, is it too late to stop dog aggression in a 12-year-old dog? She hasn't been around other dogs in 8 years because the owner is afraid it will hurt another dog again. Almost killed a dog 8 years ago.
Lindsay, you're fucked. Next. She
are you
is.
Serious?
She's fucked.
Are you serious?
8 years, no dog interaction. The last experience with the dog, it killed it. There's been no training since then. She's fucked.
You're fucked. Oh my God.
You know, hopefully the dog's too slow to move. Listen, it's 12 years old. It's going to bite a dog. Its teeth are going to fall out. No, it's not too late. I just don't know. Stop laughing. We have a show to do. No.
Okay. Fuck.
I could grab anybody at this point.
You told somebody you want to sit in.
So listen, what I want you to do is this. I don't know your skill set. No, it's not too late. It's not too late at all. But what I would start doing is start getting the dog to be around other dogs, muzzle up the dog. So muzzle train the dog, get the dog around other dogs. And I also don't know if you know how to rehab a two-year-old dog from aggression. So what's your skill set? Know the dog is not too old at all. For all we know, the dog's got Alzheimer's. It doesn't remember it was dog aggressive. It might even think it's a fucking French poodle and it's the happiest dog can be. Next.
I can't. So done. Kevin, Jeff, why do so many dog owners leave their dogs in a hot car? It's an epidemic.
Because I encourage them to. And I've got a big audience.
Because I'm crying.
This is the thing. This is the thing. Okay? You're a headline reader. I don't think a lot of people leave their dogs in hot cars. I don't think they do. I don't think a lot of people abuse their dogs. I think people are great with their dogs. People usually take better care of their dogs than they do their kids or themselves. I think you're a headline reader. But people go nuts, okay? I'm in my car. The air conditioning is on. The car is locked. The air conditioning is on. I run in to get some bottled water from somewhere. I come out, and someone's ready to smash my window. Like, what's the difference between if I would have stopped, got on my cell phone in front of the store? What is the difference? There is none. People have gone off the deep end. That doesn't mean I'm ignoring the fact that people don't leave their kids and dogs in hot cars. I know they do. But I don't think it's as big of a problem as other things. I think more dogs are running out the front door, don't have recall, and are getting hit by cars. I think more dogs, because of bad training, are ending up in shelters being killed. I don't think dogs being left in cars is a newsworthy problem at all. I just don't. And I could be wrong, but I just don't. I'm not seeing it. Yes, I see the headlines. So if a dog is left in a car right now, tonight, 5 minutes later, the whole world knows about it, and everybody signed the fucking petition. But I don't think it's that big of a problem. Next.
Tim, your intro to e-collar video shows stim and say come with leash pressure. Would it be done different with new collars with tone, such as tone, say come, stim with leash pressure, if not complying?
No. Tone is a totally added... Now, okay. If you want to train with tone, yes. But we only use tone, and we actually use tone as a negative marker. We use tone as a negative marker for if we want to say no to a dog, but we're not in the room and it follows up with a punisher, which would be shock, you can use tone. But you can use tone as anything. You can teach the dog what it means. That's up to you. Next.
Scattered Storm, two parts, three parts. You better watch it. Just kidding. She always says this. Hey guys, had a nice time with my dog this morning. Michael's doesn't advertise itself as dog friendly, but it is, which means most people don't take their out of control dogs in. And they didn't bitch about me dropping the leash as the dog held a near perfect downstay while I shopped in the aisle. Three people asked the pet. I said no, of course, but I'm glad they asked.
That was nice. So
that is nice.
Dog friendly and polite people. Next.
Sammy, weird stuff has been going on my end tonight. It didn't even notify me that the show was starting, nor did it let me ask any questions beforehand like normal. Anyway, we're all here now.
Awesome.
It's because you didn't turn on notifications.
What's that?
You didn't turn on the chat.
No, it's got nothing to do with it. I'm also,
what are you doing?
For some reason, I don't have battery power.
Oh, that's not good.
Nope.
Are you plugged in?
Okay, but don't unplug anything because... Oh, got it now. Next.
Okay. James. Hey, guys, just found you. Have a 12-year-old black lab mix. Had... For 4 weeks. She barks louder and louder when I'm out of sight, escalates, then she poops and pees. Is a bark collar okay, or is this normal?
Well, it's normal, but it's not acceptable. So a bark collar is fine. Next.
Annie, was I just corrected? Okay, so new message. Joelle, you look super cute tonight, and I love your hair. I can't see anyone else on the screen. Thanks, Annie.
See that?
So nice.
See, well-trained audience. Very good.
Mm-hmm. JP. Hey guys, love the show. Want to thank you for all the free info. Are you coming to Michigan anytime soon?
I don't think that's one of the states I'm allowed to by my probation officer, so no. But
the next closest one, though.
But the next closest one is Elkhart, Indiana, and Ohio. I'm going to be
there. You're from Ohio, too.
No, I can go to Ohio. Oh. No, when I was a young kid,
it was Cleveland Heights.
Cleveland Heights. Okay. When I was a young kid. Sure. Yeah. I was got banned from Cleveland Heights. Next.
Mario.
That's what happens when you sleep with a police chief's daughter.
And you drive a van.
Drive a van.
Mario says, hi, guys. Happy Friday.
16-year-old kid, pick up your daughter in the van.
Who would ever allow that to happen?
Well, I parked it down the street and I walked.
Come back to my shaggin' wagon.
I didn't go with a shaggin' wagon.
That's what it was, though.
Of course it was. I lost my virginity. No, I didn't. I lost my virginity in the deli. No, in the back of her car. Nice. I remember that. Yeah,
so she had the shaggin' wagon.
It was a car. It was her husband's car. Yeah, I was a kid too. I was like, I won't even say how young I was. I was too young. Yes.
Oh my god.
Yep.
I know too much about you. Antonio says thank you.
You're welcome, Antonio.
For what? For what?
I don't know. Not sleeping with his daughter, I guess. I don't know.
Kim, dog has been using the treadmill well for months now, but has started whining after about 15 minutes walking. I don't think it's pain related.
It could be anxious. You know, it could be maybe it's going too slow. Maybe it's going too fast. It could be boredom. It could be maybe the dog is, you know, has got a repetitive injury. Dogs whine for many, many reasons. Next.
Nicole, Jeff, was your Mal Tex 100% trained when you got him? I find myself using mine's breed as an excuse as to why she picks and chooses when to respond to punishers. She seems perfect one day and nuts the next.
Well, so Tex came to us about a year prior to me getting him, and he came to us with human and dog issues and lots of separation anxiety. And when I got him, he struggled. He had his struggles, but I'd call him far from perfectly trained, but he came to me awesome. I mean, he did come to me awesome. And he's done better since he's been with me, because he's just falling into the routine, because I didn't really put a lot of training on him, but just the routine that I have with my dogs, they just fall into a really, really a pretty simple routine. So, but I think if your dog is a selective listener, I don't think it's the breed. It's most likely the person holding the leash. So let's own up to that. Next.
Carlo, hello from Jacksonville, Florida. You guys are awesome. Our dogs are well behaved because of your videos.
Awesome. And your hard work. I really am. Guys, it's really important. Trust me. Thank you for saying thanks. I really appreciate it. But what I really want people to know is, I'll say this, like I say every show, I'm the guy with the big mouth. I'm just the guy that makes the videos, has the big mouth, gives out the free advice, which half the time is absolutely inappropriate. And you're doing the hard work. And I don't want to say I'm amazed, because amazed like I'm surprised anybody listens. But I also like to be almost as bold as saying is, if you've got a badly behaved dog now, there's really no excuse. Because I'm not the only one giving out free information. There's a lot of free information out there. There's books. There's videos. There's downloading streams. A lot of it is free. There's Q&As, myself, and I know 20 of my colleagues that do Q&A shows. And there's enough free and inexpensive classes out there. And you can figure this stuff out yourself. And I think that if you're willing to put in the hard work, you can have, you know, we're not talking about competition, world-class obedience, but a dog that you can pretty much take wherever you want. Next.
Jeannie, since our Skype, our six-year-old dog, aggressive dog, has been having lots of awesome playtime in the field with our puppy.
Wow.
We'd only been having her coexist with. It's been so great.
Thanks. Awesome. Proud of you. Next.
Double DD, hey gang, love to all. I have a pointer bull terrier who is brutal for nail trims at home. Real brat, bucking and mouthing. Last eve, it took 3 serious bonks and I was able to trim and dremel. Hell yeah.
There you go. Yeah, we had a little nail incident right before the show started. So they're still mopping up the blood. I'm really not, it sounds like it's working for you. If anybody out there is struggling with nail stuff, I suggest looking for groomer YouTube videos. Groomers have got skill sets. They've got good groomers have incredible just dog handling skills. There's groomers that don't put up with shit. Imagine this. The dog is at a level that the dogs are not at the level with me. They're like at face level. I'm rarely ever face level. Like even with a Great Dane, I'm not at face level, you know, with the dog. So groomers have got, some skills. So groomer videos for that next.
Scattered Storm. Also, I taught my dog a new trick. It's called, you know you're not allowed to mouth or jump on me. This includes during playtime. He returned with the toy, and I kicked him when he tried to jump on me. He learned fast.
Wow, awesome. Good job kicking. It's my advice. Kicking
and swinging.
That's good.
Feisty pet training and boarding. No problem, Jeff. Take care of your own over there. We will live over on the Patreon page. You're teaching us duration, LOL.
So, guys.
10 years, bit.
Guys, it's on my list. I'm going to make up for it. I'm going to make up for it. We've already talked about that.
I have a lot of stuff I need you to do, too, though. The list just keeps growing.
It's Joelle's fault. Okay.
I'll take the blame.
No, I'm going to be putting stuff up on Patreon. I'll get there next.
Crick says, hi, guys. My dog was leash reactive, fence guarding, tire biting, nervous, fearful dog. Everyone that's struggling, don't give up. With Jeff's help, I basically trained a deaf feral dog.
Wow. Holy shit. Damn. Thank you. Look at you, superstar. Next.
Julie, I'm sorry. I meant to say we are walking great using the leash pressure with the prong collar to give small corrections to her heel. I was giving a compliment.
That's a big fucking difference in what came out of her mouth.
Yeah.
It sounded like you were still struggling.
She said lots of leash pressure.
Okay, cool. Awesome.
Rick says, yes, sir. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Eric, love you guys and gals. Learned so much and still learning. Thanks.
Awesome. Yeah, me too. Every day. Next.
Victor, recall training at 5 months. How should I go about that? With love from Detroit.
Hey, Detroit, what's up? This is what you can do. Start out, I've got a video on that, so start out with watching my YouTube video, and what you can do is you're going to start out with just a remote collar or a prong collar and a long line and food and dog training. So watch the video. Next.
Sammy, when you say to teach the dog to just exist around people and not allow people to give food or pet, is that method only for dogs with fear issues or to socialize all dogs that way?
Okay, so the first 6 months of a dog's life, I want the dog to meet as many people as possible. I'm fortunate that I live in Providence, so I'm actually a minority. So it's really, really great that the people here, multicultural, different looks, different heights, different, our school system has 90 languages spoken in it. So, I mean, it's like very multicultural in our city. So the dog just learns to meet a lot of different people and nothing really fazes the dog. If you really want to see some incredible dogs, New Orleans, all the gutter punks, and that is their name, they're gutter punks, but look at their dogs. These dogs are like neutral to everything, everything. And why? Well, they've got 24/7 exposure to the world, and nothing fazes them. So, but one of the things is, at the beginning of the life, I want my dog to be, you know, I do want my dog to, so my dogs are social. They're social with dogs, and they're social with humans, meaning they can get along with dogs and humans, but they just don't meet them. They exist with them. So that's a policy I have. That's my personal preference for what I want from my dogs. Now, from a professional level, the dogs that we get in here on board and train probably should also be abiding by that because they're not in the right behavior to be meeting other dogs or meeting people. They should be existing around them. And I think if some people really think about it, I think they probably would enjoy that as well. Now, some people, they get their happiness from having people pay attention to their dogs. That gives them happiness. Don't get me wrong. I do like to watch dogs play, but I'm fortunate, I guess, that I've got multiple dogs. So I enjoy watching my dogs play. Next.
Rick says, thanks for all you do. I just appreciate it.
I appreciate you too, Rick. Thanks.
Monica, how do I get my puppy to listen and not snap at me when I'm trying to settle him down or get him out of a room he shouldn't be in? Sometimes he listens. Most of the time he growls and runs all over.
Okay. We have an age there?
No, puppy.
So puppy is like 8 weeks to 13 months, you know, so not in my world, but in clients' world. So no, it sounds like your dog just isn't trained. It sounds like your dog's also not on a leash. So it also sounds like your dog doesn't know basic commands, which is, this is not a blaming thing. So let's start with training. Number one, your dog should be on a leash in the house. So you have 100% control over it. Let's start with lots of structure. So if you really think about it, if the dog was in a room and had a leash on it, it's as simple as just grabbing the leash and walking. Let's go. Dog's out of the room. So that's what makes it really, really easy. But let's start with teaching that dog all its basic commands. So come to me, go over there, lie down, stop barking, go in your crate, come out of your crate. You know, all the basic commands. We'll start with that next. I think the bar that we've set with our dogs is really, really low as a country. And I would love to see every dog at least know basic commands. I really feel strongly that every dog out there, if you can't take your dog, put it in a downstay in a coffee shop, then you should be watching our free content and you should be working. Not that that's like the pinnacle of dog training, but like that's to me is just minimum standards of owning a dog. Next.
Candy. Hi, Jeff and Joelle. I have a high energy dog who knows how to wait to be released before coming out of the crate. But once he does, he bolts out and is super hyped up. Yep. Is the bonker the way to correct?
You could. I would actually just keep a leash on that dog and have it come out and go right into a sit. Next.
Rick, that should have said, thank you very much, Jeff. LOL.
Oh, what did it say?
I don't know. He's thanked you like 5 times.
Okay,
just,
Rick.
Just appreciate the
thank you. Oh, thanks, Rick.
Lindsay, I'll let you know how she does at the end of T3 before I leave the building. Existence is my goal. I think I can get her to exist and let dogs walk by. I just want to give the owners the best hope.
Awesome. Cool.
Michelle, critter issue. 9-month pit mastiff ignores cats, rabbits, squirrels, all okay. Fledgling wrens are diving my dog into the garden. He looks to me and I say no. Okay to let him defend?
What the fuck's a fledgling wren?
Fledgling wren? I don't know. Some sort of bird. A baby
bird? It's attacking the dog?
A fledgling is a baby bird, right? Mm-hmm. So it's diving into the dog in the garden. Should she let the dog defend itself?
Yeah.
I would.
Yeah, I'd save on your food bill, that's for sure. Yeah, let the dog. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, of course. I mean, let the buyer beware. Let the fucking wrens learn how not to fledge and dive bomb.
I mean, fledge, those damn
If any animal was attacking my dog, I would just like let nature take its course. Next.
Fledglings are fledging.
Yes, whatever they're doing. Okay, please don't use complicated words, guys, on my show. I don't understand them. Next.
Just got my first e-collar. Have my family watching your videos to get them on board. Thanks for all the content.
Awesome. Wow, impressive. Next.
Rye bread. That sounds good. What about these booties for dogs that are always slipping off of or out of place?
What about them? I don't know. What about them? I'm just thinking about booty shorts there for a second. I don't.
Dog booty.
I guess they're no good. I don't know. I don't know anything about booties for dogs. Next.
Ari, keep it G-rated, would you? She says, yes, I did see my comment of the year. I'll stroke Jeff and his ego every day of the week. Ha ha. On another note, my bull Arab is still eating poop after 100 correction. Must be fucking good shit. Have you tried putting pineapple in it?
Okay, this is what you're going to do, all right? I want you to get a hose. I want you to get a sparklet bottle, you know, the sparklet bottles, like the water bubbler bottles, and I want you to have the remote collar. And what I want you to do is I want you to, like, figure out all three of those things, and your dog's going to go over and eat the poop, and you pick the way you're going to do it. Hose the dog in the face, throw the bottle at the dog, and shock him. Like, we're talking boom, 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 overload. Next.
Let's see. Monica, greetings. Love the show. Yesterday, I left my dog on air-conditioned car for 3 minutes. A woman started screaming at me, called me an asshole, and all sorts of things. Oh, well.
Yep. I know. It's gotten out of hand. Next.
Eric, Jeff, I know you have tons of e-collar videos, but do you have one that's like A to Z for e-collar? Still consider myself undereducated on them. Thanks.
No, I don't. Go to thegooddogway.com and you can get them there. Next.
Heather S., I have a dog who pushes other dogs under the water and then tries to swim over them. Should I just correct with remote when he starts to get close to them? Damn.
Yes, you can. In fact, I don't know if I still have this video. There was a Rottweiler I worked with a long time ago. Probably over 10 years ago. And because Clover was in the pool. So Clover is 14. She probably was, swimming. So probably 9 years ago. And the Roddy would swim at her and it bumped, you know, hit her a couple of times. And I'm like, Clover, let me do this one more time. Because I didn't know it was happening, but I wasn't prepared for it. So the Roddy started swimming towards her, and right before it got to her, I corrected that dog high, and it literally turned right around. So I'd use the remote collar for that. Next.
Rye Bread, could you do a live demo bonk? Thanks, Jeff. Long time since I've caught a live. Love them. Take care.
I've got probably 500 different scenes of me bonking dogs. I bonk dogs every day of my life. So we've got lots of content of bonking. I have to be careful on where I put it because I can get deplatformed. So if it's considered animal abuse and I put it up on YouTube, I can actually be kicked off this platform and then look at all these videos that can't help people. So we do have a platform that we can put bonking videos on. We just haven't started putting content on it yet. Melissa, have we? Help me out there with that, Melissa. Send me an email and let me know where we can put our bonking videos without getting into trouble. But it actually is, it's a major problem. So people see one of my videos and they hit the abuse button without even watching them. So I'm always getting reports from YouTube about that. Next.
Cherise says, oh my God, Jeff, you're in rare form tonight.
Oh, this is my usual thing, but okay, cool. Thanks.
Monica, my dog didn't even wake up. I wish he defended me or something. The birds. The birds diving him. He didn't even wake up.
What?
The fledglings diving this dog.
But that means they didn't hit the dog.
He didn't wake up. I don't know.
Well, I mean, that means they must not have come into the dog.
Yeah, but they're probably just swooping.
Okay. Next.
What are you getting all defensive for?
I just don't understand it's the fledgling word.
James, hey again, just to clarify, my black lab mix is 12 weeks old. Seems like separation anxiety. Is bark collar okay for the age, or is her barking when I leave normal?
Oh, that's a big difference, because when you said 12, they'd say 12, right?
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, so what I want you to do I want you to educate yourself on how to raise a puppy, number one. So get a good book on how to raise a puppy so you understand different stages. It is absolutely normal for a 12-week-old dog to shit and piss everywhere and to always be whining and barking. That doesn't mean that you want to live like that. So you need to learn how to stop all that. I would not use a bark collar on a 12-week-old puppy. But I will bonk one. I will finger poke one. I will shake the crate. I will hit the top of the crate. I will do all of those things. But I will not use a bark collar on a 12-week-old puppy. Next.
All hail Aloria. My dog is very fearful of strangers, mostly when they look at him or try to talk to him. I tell them to not do that so I can correct the behavior. Am I right? Wouldn't e-collar help to correct this too?
Well, you can't tell strangers not to look at your dog. You just can't.
But to try to talk to him?
You can't tell a stranger not to talk to your dog.
I would.
So I can't walk down the street and say, hey, dog, and you're going to yell at me and I don't even skip a beat? I'll fucking talk to any dog I want to.
So.
Okay. That doesn't make sense. You can't control people's voices like that.
So.
Now,
okay.
Can you keep a person from stopping and like trying to touch your dog?
That's what
absolutely.
I'm envisioning, is them being like literally stopping and like, oh my God.
That's even pushing it sometimes. I mean, you know, I mean, move out of the way. Move out of the way. So, but yes, correct your dog. Or how about this? Let's proof your dog on how not to react around people talking. So set it up in a training situation. Next.
New Jersey Dogs Training LLC, T3 Clash, July 2019. Appreciate all your support and knowledge. Your team at Solid Canine are awesome. Thank you. I'm assuming that's somebody here.
Yes.
Hi. Woo!
Yes. The guy that looks like he's in Cancun right now.
Yeah, well, good for you. He's right. Having a good time.
Definitely doesn't look like he's from New Jersey. Yes, right, right.
Judy, I'm a lurker, but I always learn things. Thanks for the passion.
Thanks, Judy. I like the lurkers. Thank you.
Dre, hey, A-Team.
Hey, how are you?
Candy, if a dog has true dog aggression, will it still lash out even though it's tired?
Yeah, tired. Tired doesn't mean much. I mean, Mike Tyson was probably tired in a lot of them fights, and look what he did. So, I mean, tired has nothing to do with anything. Let's get rid of the dog aggression. Next. And okay, hold on. I think maybe what we're going for is if you tire the dog out, the aggression will stop. Was that the real question? Because that was an interesting question. So I'm thinking into this a little bit. I don't understand fledgling, but I think into things a lot. So it sounds to me like if you tire your dog out, it won't be aggressive. That's bullshit. So your dog could be fresh and perky and not aggressive if you rehab the dog. Next.
Cass says, where are you located?
Providence, Rhode Island, 25 Acorn Street, Providence, Rhode Island, 02903. Next.
Terry says, come to Sedona, Arizona.
I will be, I'll tell you what, you come to Las Vegas this year. For 2019, come to Vegas. It's in September. 2020, I most likely will be doing, I usually do, Arizona, I do usually Phoenix or Tucson. Next.
Nicole, sorry for so many questions. Just wondering if you think a Skype would even be helpful for advice on working with a Mal. I feel like what I'm doing might not be enough for her, and I want to do all that I can.
That's the one breed of dog that Skypes don't work on. I think a Skype would be, sorry. It's like, and I assure you, when I do my Skypes, I'm not snarky at all. I'm very professional. So this is the thing. Chances are you're going to pick up things from me because it's one-on-one, it's you and I, it's a minimum half an hour, and I'll be able to ask you all the right questions, and we have direct, we're having a conversation that's two-way. Right now it's not two-way, it's 15-minute delayed. So yes, it will definitely help. There's probably at least 25 things that you're not doing that if I told you to do, your life would be better. Next.
Julie, we are also working on muzzle training conditioning too.
Awesome. So
$10 top chat.
$10. I was going to say there's a Nicole E. $2.99 top chat. For some weird reason, I really don't like this because I appreciate if you gave me 10 cents. Anything less than $4.99, YouTube doesn't bring it to the top. So they just put it in the stream, but I just saw one for $2.99 from Nicole E. Thank you so much. Top chat for
$10. $10 from Terry. Thanks for all your free videos. GSD puppy, 7 months, walking perfectly on a prong collar, and it is so enjoyable.
Nice. Awesome. Congratulations. Good job, Terry.
Karen, GSD lover. Hi, Jeff and Joelle. Since I've put my dog through a structured lifestyle, our relationship drastically improves. He's so well-behaved and obedient now. Thanks for your help.
Awesome. My pleasure. Good job.
Anne, hi Jeff, it's Anne. Please ask your audience to express op. Oh, geez, I'm not reading that. Sorry,
What does it say?
I don't know. Something weird that I wasn't paying attention to.
Opposition to the Mass Senate bill. Okay. Anne.
What are you doing, Anne?
Anne.
I'm just reading questions here.
I know, Anne. Anne's a T3 student. Anne.
Oh, that's Anne.
Put it on your own damn page. No, I'm not pushing your agenda on my page, Anne, okay? But that doesn't mean I don't love you. I love you. I treasure you. You're fantastic. I want to see you. I want to go out for lunch with you. I do, but I just don't do that. You'll never see me put anybody else's agenda on my page. You won't see me put other people's agenda on my show. What is she fighting for? Maybe it's something I believe in, though.
I don't know. Massachusetts
Senate Bill 118. Oh, is that what they're doing?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Got it. And I'll tell you what.
If it passes, Rhode Island is next.
Okay. So oppose Massachusetts 118.
Oppose it.
This is the thing, guys. The government needs to stay out of stupid stuff. So regulating dog training, everybody thinks it's great. Why? One dog probably died in the care of a dog trainer. Okay, is that one dog too many? Yeah. You know how many dogs die every day in a lot of situations? Like at the vet office, at daycares, walking down the street, from heat exhaustion. Obviously, millions of dogs are dying in hot cars, as we know. So this is the thing. You know, the way they want to do this is they want to certify dog trainers. The problem with that is this is the Trojan horse. Just like shock collars are the Trojan horse. In Vancouver, British Columbia, legislation just did not pass. This was all one legislative, like, vote on this. Shock collars, yay! Prong collars, yay! Choke chains, yay! I want to vote against that stuff. Okay, hold on, the list isn't done. You can't say no to your dog. Oh. Yeah, you're not fucking cheering anymore, are you? Okay, this is how it starts. These are Trojan horses, okay? So the regulation of dog trainers is supposed to make what? It's safer for whom? There is the Better Business Bureau. There is the Secretary of State. There is an Animal Abuse Registry. If someone is abusing a dog, there are ways to report it. Okay? In Hillsborough, Florida, where they're trying to pull all of this shit with Sarge's Law, with abuse, do you know that there's two people on the Animal Abuse Registry? Two. Just two. So if it was a problem, why is there only two? It's not a problem. We have things in place already. We don't need more legislation. And also, it's really important before you sign any legislation at all, before you vote on any legislation, ask this important question. Who's paying for it? Who's paying to enforce it? Who's paying to go answer the complaint? Who's paying the judge to sit there to listen to the complaint? And then, please. So, Anne, see that? Got what you want. Next.
See,
No more questions, Anne. Next.
Are you done?
Yes.
Are you sure?
I said next.
Sammy, I understand kicking a dog if the dog is coming after you or your dog, but why are we advocating kicking a dog in the instance in which it was previously mentioned? Jumping.
I didn't say to kick a dog if it's jumping.
He jumped, but somebody said they kicked their dog for jumping on them.
Okay. I don't mean I'm guys, like, there's a lot worse things than kicking your dog. I think you're looking, is that what you picked up from this whole show? Like, this whole show, this whole time I've been talking, that's what you took out of this. That I don't even remember that. So what? A dog jumped on them and they kicked it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So would kneeing the dog be better? Would taking the dog and pushing it off of you be better? How would you like to get your dog to come off of you or your child? Explain it. Tell it to sit. So I don't know if I'm, just because I said okay, that doesn't mean I'm encouraging people to kick the dog. But if I've got a dog, if one of my German shepherds jumped up on me and I gave my dog a foot tap, a kick, I wouldn't think that was really any big deal. Am I going around saying you should just kick your dog if it doesn't do a downstay or if it doesn't sit? Or you should come home and just kick your dog? No. But do you know that dogs are knocking people over and they're breaking bones from being jumped on? That's a huge problem. Talk to any emergency room tech. Talk to any doctor about injuries from dogs. Being pulled over on walks and being knocked over is very high. Dog bites, not as high. Or maybe it's the same frequency, but I assure you, the expense to fix it in the rehab process is worse. So giving your dog a foot tap or kicking it for jumping on you is not a big deal. Do we do that here at our training center? No, we don't. But have I given my dog a boot at home? Yes, I have. Have I given my dog a quick whack on the nose? Absolutely. Have I given a spank the dog in the ass? I sure have. Have I had a dog that was about a dog that has a history of dog aggression and it did some dominant posturing over a new dog I brought in my house? Have I given that dog a good boot to freaking make sure there was not a dog fight? Absolutely. And I have no problem with that whatsoever. Because when you work with some serious dogs, you realize that it's really no big deal. It's none whatsoever. And if people learned how to better handle their shit, handle their dogs with their hands and feet, we'd have a hell of a lot more problems. And if people want to keep, countries want to keep banning tools out there, guess what? There's going to be a lot of more hitting and kicking and hanging dogs and using tree branches and broomsticks and all kinds of shit on your dog. So I have no problem with that at all. Is that our standard operating procedure? No, it's not. But I don't think it's that big of a deal. Next.
Julie, I do have one question.
Yes.
You say to keep a dog on a leash inside the house?
An untrained dog that is not under voice control, yes, I do. And I'm not angry either. I'm just passionate as fuck. But you do realize that millions of dogs are dying every year in shelters for easy, correctable things. And if it takes a little bit of, you know, what people consider abuse, that's not abuse. Abuse is not, yeah, I'm going to go off on this. I won't shut the fuck up, obviously. But if you think that, you know what's abuse? Not stopping a bad behavior so your dog doesn't get sent to the shelter and can rot there, that's abuse. I'm sorry. If I'm going to give my dog one freaking boot and it stops a behavior forever, Who cares? Come on, guys, please. Enough snowflake bullshit. The fucking shovels are put away. Next. No, I'm just sorry. People fucking just get, they freak out about small things.
Oh my God, Crixis, $10. Thanks for all you do too, Joelle.
It's awesome.
Good, am I going to get that $10? Here we go, I just, Shit. Thanks, Crixis.
You want to see my your credit card bill of your expenses? Okay. What does it cost me to travel with you?
God, I shouldn't have said it. All right. Sorry. Candy says, okay. I'll start doing
so that. So next next flight that we're in first class, you'll be in coach. And don't you dare.
You can't. You can't put me back there.
And don't complain. Pretty nice sitting in first class in that sleeper seat across the...
Yeah, but I'm productive as fuck when we get to our destination.
Oh, okay.
All right. Yeah. And I get video editing done.
All right.
Scattered storm.
You can do that from coach, too.
He's a working line GSD. He ain't made of glass. After I kicked him, he eyed me and pranced away. I whack him with stuffed drink dog. Doesn't faze him at all.
Thank you.
He likes the resistance and pushback.
Yes.
Sounds like a dog. I
yeah. Anybody that's ever worked with a working line dog, trust me, a boot ain't a big deal. Next.
No. Nicole did $2.99.
Awesome.
Rye bread. Booties are booty. Thumbs down. I've seen people claim dog abuse and we're burning the pads if we don't put the booties on.
Oh, like
put the booties on.
Okay, so this is the thing. Yes, I guess if you're in Vegas, you're in Florida, you're in Phoenix, Arizona, and the ground is hot, you got to be careful, obviously. So, but I don't think the lack of booties is dog abuse or putting booties on is dog abuse. If you want to put a tutu on your fucking dog, you go right ahead. I don't care. Next.
Shit, I just lost my spot. Sorry.
Did you?
Hold on. Yeah.
Okay. JeffGellmanSeminars.com, SolidCanineTraining.com. Hello, everybody.
Show the audience, quick. All right, here we are. Candy Anderson says yes. Scattered Storm. Jeff, I'm doing a poster on a dog training, and I know you don't like the quadrants, but it was the simplest way to explain balance training. I listed you as a source. Can I tag you on IG when I post it?
No. Next.
Rye bread.
I don't want to be associated with quadrants.
Rye bread.
Yes, go ahead. But no, because I don't know if you're going to get the damn quadrants.
I can't be associated with quadrants.
I don't know if you're going to do it right. You can do whatever you want. You can tag my name. I can't control that. Next.
Rye bread says, yes, Las Vegas here.
All right.
It's going to be a good one.
It's going to be a good one. There's three tickets left for dinner with me, by the way, and Joelle.
I guess I'll be there, too, if I'm still allowed.
Right.
It fits the budget. bring me back the scrap.
You have to buy your own ticket.
Cool.
Next.
I'll pay to go to dinner with you.
Next.
Jeannie, so our dog will lunge occasionally at the cat or dog who comes near her crate. We want to set her up and spread some kibble, then correct her when the puppy comes to eat it. How high is necessary?
Say that one more time.
It's a mouthful. Our dog will lunge occasionally at the cat or dog who comes near her crate.
Okay, got it.
We want to set her up and spread some kibble to correct it.
Got it. So, yeah, so put food in the crate, put the dog in the crate.
How high is necessary, though?
So, but first of all, hold on here. I mean, we have to think about this. If the dog's eating food in the crate and the puppy comes right up to the crate, that puppy should be corrected, frankly. And the cat should be bonked. Mm-hmm. Sorry. Let the other dog eat in peace. Now, if the cat's walking by, that's a different story. If the dog's walking by, that's a different story. But to answer your question, how high? High enough for to stop the behavior if you decide to go that route. Next.
Thad, our trainer wants a firm pop for a correction. Is it the firmness or the timing?
Ask your trainer. Next.
Tim, pre-walk correction. If using e-collar instead of bonker, am I using level 100 for 1 to 3?
No. God, no. Jesus Christ, no. No. Pre-walk, no. 100 is 100. You save 100 for the big stuff like poop eating and counter surfing and getting in the trash. And no, it's just enough to get the dog to go, holy shit, you're taking this dog, this walk seriously. Next.
Ann said, Jeff, I did put it on my page. Dude, this is your agenda too. You just got called out.
And I talked.
And she said, Los Andes, you're taking her ass to dinner too for that.
Okay. And. You're shaking the table. And I talked about it, hon. And I told you I preceded with how much I love you. Next.
She doesn't care. You have to buy her dinner now.
Okay.
Victor.
I'm the one that helped you get divorced, damn it. Next.
He helps everybody get divorced. And Jeff, I already read that.
Yes.
Victor, how to teach dog not to swallow water while swimming.
I actually don't know how to do that. I've got a dog that does that in the ocean, and she throws up every time. Next.
Feisty pet training and boarding. I wish I could come to your seminar in Seattle in December. In 2020, don't do Washington seminar in the winter. The driving sucks. Trying to talk to my hubby into going with me to Alaska or Hawaii. See you.
Well, hold on here. We'll definitely do Alaska or Hawaii, but Seattle in the winter, it's not winter. There won't be snow there.
Mm-hmm. That's what we said last time we went.
No, you'll be fine. You'll be fine there. I mean, unless you're driving over, like, you've got to drive over the mountains to get there. But just fly. Next.
Anne says, yes, they want to regulate dog trainers. They want to license us. Thanks, Jeff. This is serious crap.
I agree 100%. Sorry for blowing the steam on that one. Next.
Nincompute. My dog is freaked out. I'm talking mortified of hot air balloons. He has jumped the fence and started a panic run down the street.
Where do you live? Utah or Arizona?
Advice.
I
know, hot air balloons. So, I don't think I've ever actually seen one.
So get a gun and shoot him from the sky.
God.
So
you're scaring my dog.
So hold on here. What's the dog doing?
It runs away, please.
Okay. So what I want you to do is this: teach the dog to not run away. So does it have a fenced in yard?
It jumps the fence.
Jumps the fence. So correct the dog for jumping the fence. You can use a remote collar and a long line for that. Make it suck. What I would do is I would counter condition your dog against hot air balloons, though. Next.
I accidentally hit somebody. Terry, I'm so sorry. I don't know how to unhide you. Shayna, recently for a second time, I was voted top pro on a dog training site. I owe part of that to you and your help. So in the spirit, I am paying. I wanted to pay it forward no sooner than done.
Okay.
No sooner said than done. I don't know.
Thank you.
Carlo, my brother was looking for a private trainer for his dog, recommended him to watch your videos. I think it's better than most private dog trainers or other training videos. It's effective and it's free.
Cool. Awesome. Thank you.
Shayna, while walking a dog I'm training, I saw a guy struggling with his GSD. Very politely, I offered to help him for free. One lesson with prong collar. He was very appreciative. And no, I do not usually walk over to people.
Good.
Shayna, I was also...
That was nice of you.
Were you going to say something?
No. Oh. That was it. It was nice. Oh, okay. That was nice of her.
I was just so happy to be voted top pro a second time and wanted to share the props with you.
Awesome. I'm happy for you.
Jane, I've been binge watching your videos. This is my first live session. You're the best.
Awesome. Thank you.
Scattered Storm, I also want to say that I'm 17, I'm short, and my dog is double my strength, a third of my weight, and I could send me to the hospital without even trying. I'd kick him again if he jumped. Not sorry, ever.
Yeah, don't defend your choice of using your feet on your dog. I have no problem with that at all. Next.
Sal says, gotta thank you for showing proper prong collar use and compressed air. I have a rescue pit bull and almost had to give him back due to pulling and lunging at other dogs, but he's improved tremendously.
Awesome.
Digital processing system. My 21-month-old pit has broke my finger, my butt bone, and I've had 4 stitches in my ankle. Thanks to Jeff's videos, my pit is now very well behaved. Thanks for those bonkers and the prong collar.
Awesome. Yeah, it sucks. Dogs injure people. I don't know if people realize that. Yes.
Tim, will I be locked into using e-collar for the rest of my dog's life if I want it to obey when, not if, it becomes collar-wise?
Not necessarily, but you have you not even started yet? A lot of people, they ask that question, they haven't even started. And I think that's just an excuse not to even go down that path. I think your depends on your skill sets, but my dogs are naked and means they don't wear equipment and they listen to me because at this point now we use relationship training. So I think that all depends on your skill set. So that's up to you. Next. But hold on here. But let's say it did. Let's say every time you were off leash out in the open, in the woods, at the beach, you know, and it had to have a remote collar on. So what? If that's what it takes for you to have tons of fun and freedom with your dog and to get your dog to listen to you, so what? Next.
Keith, wife treats the dogs like babies. I've corrected for bad behavior but get yelled at for it. What would Jeff do?
Match.com. Next.
Didn't see that one coming. Victor, how high should a high punishment be on an e-collar?
I need more context. What are you trying to stop next?
Anne says, I wrote that after you talked. Haha, love you. Los Andes, of course. I'm taking you. That's what I meant, wise ass. Getting called out tonight. Or am I the wise ass? Because I said you had to take her to dinner. Maybe I'm the wise
ass. You're the wise ass.
That's not new.
Thank you, Anne.
Sammy, I was just asking a question for more clarification. I have a high drive black Labrador guide dog from Working Lines. Very, very high drive as a puppy.
What was the question?
Why would you justify kicking?
Oh, that's okay, Sammy. I know. Sammy, that wasn't directed at you, I don't think. And I'm not angry at you, Sammy, at all. Please understand that. You're brand new to my channel. So, you know, but I want people to understand it's no big deal to use physical force on your dog. And it's not like, oh, that's what solid canine training does. It's like, no, we don't. But every dog owner better understand how to use their hands and feet with animals. Because, you know, you never know. You never know whether it's an animal that you don't know that's coming at you or your own animal jumping on you, a friendly jump, like a dog recalling and just plowing into you and knocking you over, or a dog all of a sudden like getting ready to attack your cat or another dog. Like, you all need to understand how to stop stuff, and grabbing the dog by the collar is the best way to get bit. So you have to come up with other things. Next.
Karma, my dog has separation anxiety and follows me around the house everywhere. How do I get him to stop?
Well, number one, watch my separation anxiety video. Number two, teach the place command. Next. I've got videos on all that. Next.
Rick, he's not really scared of the air balloon. I think the noise that the balloon makes when they pull the cord,
yes,
taking off or filling the
cord. Yeah, you can counter condition that with a YouTube video, food, and a clicker. Next.
Justin, dog not responding every time to a known command. Halt with prong collar on. Prongs too short.
No, it's going to be skill set of the trainer, so skill set of you. So what I want you to do is just keep moving. Next.
Jeannie, since our dog will lunge randomly and it's hard to predict, we would put some kibble outside the crate, then correct for lunging. She's trying to set it up.
Yeah, I know. I'm just trying to envision that. It's like, put it outside the crate. The other dogs are going to come over to try to eat it, and then it'll lunge. I mean, give it a shot. Give it a shot. Next.
Sarah, I have 5 dogs. Life is generally peaceful, but I don't know how to teach 5 dogs the place command at once, or do I teach separate?
Oh, you teach separate, one at a time, and then when they start, it'll be easy. So we, in other words, did you see our video? Actually, you know what? It's a highlight. I made a highlight. So if you go onto our Instagram channel, I made a highlight. It says daycare, I believe. Watch that highlight. There's one, Kristen is in there, who's a kennel worker, but she has skill set. She's got 12 dogs out, and look what they're all doing. And each one of those dogs learned on its own, and then you put it all together. Next.
Rick, that happened to me up here, and I was out with my standard poodle. Had to teach her where the noise was coming from and why it was so terrifying for her.
Mm-hmm. Next.
Shayna, all of this certification business is only about money. And whom exactly would be in charge of setting the standards? Makes you wonder. I bet you it would be a panel of snowflakes.
You know, I actually don't think it's about money. I don't think it's about money at all, because there won't be much money involved. What's it going to be, $25, $35 a person? I don't think it's money. The expense will outweigh the profit, therefore it'll be a loss. There'll be a loss to this. There'll be a financial loss. I think it's about control. I think that's what it is. And it's also an agenda to get dogs out of homes. Please understand, please, 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 please understand that there are people out there who don't want dogs in homes, and that's where things are going. And when you vote on this, I can't, remember, these are Trojan horses. What you like to do with your dog is going to be next. So if you love agility, and you vote on this legislation in Massachusetts, I assure you, remember these words. I assure you, at one point, agility will be trying to be wiping that out as well. And fly ball, service dogs, okay? Trick training, anything competitive with a dog, it's going to try to be wiped out, and a lot of stuff will be wiped out. So be careful about empowering these hate groups, and that is what you are doing. Next.
Anne says, thank you for the divorce advice.
You're welcome, Anne.
Crystal, how stop. English, please, Crystal. How to stop a dog from pulling, I assume.
How to stop a dog from pulling. That's a 3-minute protocol. If you're not using a prong collar, stop that. Start with that right now. So I've got a video on how to pick out a size of a prong collar, how to fit the prong collar, how to introduce the prong collar, and how to start using the prong collar. Start with my free videos. Next.
Emmy, my e-collar is arriving any day now. I've watched a lot of your videos, but what is the best place to start training my dogs with it?
Try the place command. Anything in movement. Next.
Michelle, my 100-pound, 9-month pit mastiff can do more damage by accident than a lot of dogs on purpose.
Correct.
I have zero problem being physical to keep him off of me.
Anybody that owns a large breech dog, I'm sorry, you better be ready to be physical. It's just the way it works. It's the way it works. You have to be prepared to be physical. Next.
Justin, does more distraction call for a higher level on the e-collar or a harder tug on the prong?
Well, just to an untrained dog, yes. So, yes. Just remember, more distraction means louder of something. So, whether louder words, but words have no meaning right now to your dog. So, it would have to be on the remote or it would have to be more of the prong. Yes. Next.
Sarah, thank you. I will watch the Instagram. I did watch the other place video.
Awesome. But Sarah, general rule, one at a time. And then two at a time, and then three at a time, and then four at a time. Next you know, you have five dogs in place. You could accomplish that in less than a month. Next.
Christine, you were right, Jeff. It is not about money. It is completely about control.
Yeah, it is. Next.
And thank you for saying that about training. We like being wiped out by hate groups like the group backing Massachusetts Senate Bill 118. Block this stupid bill, everyone.
Yep.
Crystal says, how to teach your dog to stop barking.
The best thing, you make barking suck. So I would suggest get a bark collar or a remote collar. Next.
Sammy, I've been watching you for a while, actually, and we talked on the phone before. I'm the one who's wanted more clarification on how to bonk. I'm also on Linda's page.
Oh, cool. All right, Sammy. So then you should never... Regular. Then you should have a problem encouraging people to use their feet. Next.
Cheyenne, I live with my grandparents, not my choice. They have a poodle, and my grandma spoils him. I try to correct and she goes off. I can't live with the dog's bullshit. Condition e-collar in secret. She wants him to behave, but she won't let me do anything to fix his behavior.
So, take...
How old is your grandma?
How old is your grandmother? I mean, you could just, you know, back the car up and...
That's not where I was going. I was hoping she was senile, not like...
Oh, I thought you were trying to find ways
to... She had a good life insurance policy, too.
I thought you were trying to figure out a good way to kill her.
No.
Okay. So, I mean, slip and fall injuries are huge with the elderly. I mean,
Joelle's trying to figure it out. Okay.
Try. Do stealth dog training if you want to. Next.
Melissa. I'm trying to introduce my 15-week-old pup to my dad's dog, but she growls, shows her teeth, will turn her head away when he walks towards her. What do we do to fix this so she doesn't bite him?
I mean, it's multifaceted what you're going to do. Who's growling at who?
All right, you ready?
Yes.
Her 15-week-old pup, she's trying to introduce it to her dad's dog.
Yep.
But she, I don't know who she
is. Who's she?
I don't know which one. One of them is growling. Showing their teeth will turn their head away when he walks towards her.
Okay, well, that dog is saying, I'm uncomfortable and I want to move away. So you got to advocate for both those dogs. Let's start right there. Next.
Jeannie, so with setting up our randomly lunging dog, how high do you think is necessary? Don't want to be overly high.
Well, you're better off going over than under. Next.
Digital processing system. My pit went after a kitten. I took a dive onto my pit, LOL. Just an instant reaction.
Yeah, no shit. I've had to choke out dogs. Next.
Cheyenne, love you guys. You always know how to make me laugh.
Good, Cheyenne.
That's nice. I'm glad we make people laugh somehow.
Your laugh makes people laugh.
That's all right now.
It's infectious.
The end of the show anyway.
It's right? The end of the show. All right, guys. Thank you so much. Hold on. Where's my phone? There's usually something that comes from Melissa. Nope, nothing there from Melissa. Okay. All right. Thank you guys so much. I'm madly in love with you, Jeff Gellman and Joelle. We'll see you not Saturday night, so Monday night. We'll see you Monday night, 8 p.m. Eastern time. Check out Jeff Gellman's seminars. Don't forget, next week, next weekend, we will be in Vancouver, British Columbia. Okay, we're looking
forward. That's next week already?
It's next weekend. And then the weekend after that, you're going on vacation.
Gone like the whole month.
Yeah, that's right.
Nice knowing you.
That's right. It's great. I'm getting a vacation too with you gone.
Bye.
All right. All right, guys. Take care. Love you.
Bye.